Happy Face Entertainment introduced us to one of the best six-member girl groups ever, otherwise known as Del Shabet. Between the years of 2011 to 2019, before they just halted everything suddenly. So, what happened to them? Well, let's talk about it. Vicky, Subin, Kaeun, Seri, Jiul, and Ah Young debuted on January 3rd, 2011, with the EP and matching title track Super Dupa Diva. This was a very strong debut, in my opinion. The ladies are super confident and don't seem like rookies at all. They're letting us know that they're super hot divas and they are here to stay and slay, comparing themselves to Fire and telling us just how hot they are. I love the dance in the chorus with this song, and I feel like they executed this debut really well. The video was very fun to watch too. The outfits were a bit of a hot mess in my opinion, but it was 2011, so naturally the trends were different back then. The album placed number 9 on the charts and sold over 4.1k copies. On April 14, 2011, Del Shabet came back with another EP and matching title track called Pink Rocket. Another great song that showed the ladies' softer side. They're confessing that they've fallen in love with their romantic interest and they're comparing the sensations to a pink rocket that's taking off. The video definitely matches the outer space vibes, and I can say that the outfits here are way better than their debut. I especially love those sci-fi dresses that they wore. The darker pink and black colors in the beginning of the video were decent too, and then they ended it very strongly with more pink towards the end. So kudos to the stylists here because they knew what they were doing this time, and it really, you know, the whole pink vibe very much so goes with the title of the song. So the EP peaked at number 7 and sold over 4k copies. Then on August 11, 2011, Del Shabet gave us another EP, a matching title track called Bling Bling. From sassy to sci-fi to funky, these ladies were killing it in 2011. I mean, each project was getting better and better than the last. This was the first song that I actually ever heard of theirs back in the day, and I was sold once I saw the video. I love this dance so much. It's super catchy and fun, and then like the animations of the video was super fun to watch as well. The makeup and outfit styling was really good. And then the song itself, it's still very catchy to this day. The ladies are just having a good time and trying to, you know, invite everyone to party and live it up with them. Again, they're supposed to be rookies at this time, which is mind-boggling how amazing they were even back then. So the EP peaked at number 55 and sold over 3.6k copies. In 2012, it started out well for the ladies as it was announced in January that they'd be the new face of a Korean luxury brand known as Sanovi. So that was pretty good on them. Then on January 26, 2012, Del Shabet gave us the EP and matching title track Hit You. Yeah. thing Dal Shabet did was keep us on our toes consistently. Each comeback was drastically different than the last, and this one was no exception. This comeback had a much more mature, darker theme that we had ever previously seen from Dal Shabet, because the ladies did not come to mess around. Their ex is back in their life and they are not having it after the messy breakup that left them torn. But they're not the same as they were before back then. They're badder and slightly more vengeful now. The video is definitely worth a watch if you haven't seen it. It's super fire. It's them taking back their resolve. The dance and the outfits were on point and the acting was phenomenal overall. I was convinced at this point that there's nothing these women can't do. This comeback was loved by all because it sat at number one on the charts and it sold over 11.1k copies. On May 24, 2012, Happy Face Entertainment confirmed that leader Vicky would be parting ways with the company and Dal Shabet. According to Soompi, the agency released a statement that reads, "The leader Vicky will leave the group in order to pursue her solo activities. After getting some rest, she will begin preparations for her solo activities. Vicky debuted with Dal Shabet while bearing the thought of pursuing solo activities later in mind. For a long time, we had discussions of Vicky and her eventual solo career. The reason that she has come to this decision now is so that she can pursue her dreams before Dal Shabet's new album is released." Vicky took to the group's official fan cafe to address her departure herself in a letter, and it states, "Hello, I'm Vicky from Dal Shabet. Although it has been a long time since I have greeted you all, I have sad news for all the darlings. Because of you fans, I had a lot of happy days while being the leader of Dal Shabet. However, after the Yoso schedule, I will stop all official Dal Shabet activities." She continued by saying, "A lot of you are surprised, right? However, I will soon appear again as a solo artist. Please anticipate that. And our pretty Shabet Dawn sayings are going to come back. It will be the first official album, so I hope you give them much love." She ended it with, "Although I won't be able to greet you as a member of Dal Shabet, darlings, please do not forget the mischievous Vicky in your hearts. Please continue to love Dal Shabet and anticipate my Vicky's solo activities, where she will show new transformations. My sisters who have been with me, Charming City, Big Eyes, A Young, Sister-in-Law Prospect, Jiyul, Track and Field Idol, Gayeon, and Giant Baby Subin, I will always cheer you guys on. Darlings as well. You know how much I love you guys, right? Smooch. Thank you for all of those people who gave me love and continue to cheer me on. I will come back soon." City would become the group's new leader, and the agency added the trainee Woo Hee to the lineup. On June 6, 2012, Dal Shabet released their first full-length album called Bang Bang with the title track Mr. Bang, Mr. Bang Bang. The concept queens. Yes, I love this Western style comeback. The dance was so cute, and the video itself is hilarious and entertaining, especially when they initially start robbing the business. I really love their acting. They're just super, super good actors. And this was a great song in itself as well. The ladies are taking a more bolder and confrontational stance with this one as they're trying to get their love interest to just come out and confess his feelings for them. It's definitely worth a listen, and the video is super worth a watch if you have not done either. I don't know what's with the back-to-back gun themes, but moral of the story, you do not want to get on Dal Shabet's bad side. So the album peaked at number 7 and it sold over 4.7k copies. On October 24, 2012, Dal Shabet landed a deal with the Chinese cell phone brand Vivo to become the new face of the company. So it's another pretty good brand deal for them. On November 12, 2012, Dal Shabet came back with the EP and matching title track Have Don't Have. The the ladies are bringing us disco vibes with this comeback, and I was all here for it. The song is extremely catchy, for one. The ladies are totally smitten with their love interest, and they're just confessing their feelings through and through. The dance is super good, and the video is just as entertaining and funny to watch. I feel like they did a great job with this comeback, and they even released two videos for this project. Let me know which one is your favorite. The EP placed number 5 on the charts and sold over 3.7K copies. On June 20th, 2013, Dal Shebet released the EP and matching title track Be Ambitious. Such a phenomenal comeback. The ladies have done it again. Can we just take a moment to appreciate the dance and the outfits in this video? Literally the best they've come out with thus far. And then the song itself is just super catchy, and it's a very easy listen. The ladies are pleading to their boyfriend to notice them more and basically make a move. They're trying to entice him by getting him to look at their legs and reminding him that she might be swept away by another guy on the street if he doesn't get his act together and show more interest. So the video is very funny and entertaining, true Dal Shebet fashion. Now, this comeback was hit with some controversy when a Korean men's rights group known as Man of Korea filed a court order to ban this comeback for the lyrics, citing that they were harmful to the youth and depreciates both women and men. Eventually, the lawsuit was dropped and all was well when Happy Face confirmed it in a statement saying both parties had reached an agreement. The EP peaked at number 10 and sold over 3.2K copies. On January 8, 2014, Dal Shebet came back with the EP and title track BBB, or Big Baby Baby. Probably my favorite Dal Shebet song ever. This upbeat banger tells us about the ladies and how they're just fed up with the current standing of their relationship. Their boyfriend is acting cold and indifferent, and they're letting him have it in this comeback. They're showing us their darker, mature colors once again, and they killed it. The outfits are on point, the dance literally slayed me, and they look like models the entire time. I don't know how they dance like that in those shoes. The video is simplistic but still worth a watch for the dance itself. I still play this song a lot because it's just that amazing. The EP peaked at number 7 and it sold over 5.4K copies. On May 23rd, 2014, disaster struck in Busan once it was reported that Soobin had been involved in a vehicular accident after wrapping up filming for NBC's Everyone's 9 to 6 2. According to Soompi, a rep from the agency gave a statement to the media that reads, "Soobin will have to have an operation to reset a broken bone. The doctors have checked her condition very thoroughly. It has been decided that surgery is the best idea and will be the best course of action if she is to make a quick recovery." It was also confirmed that Soobin will indefinitely be gone on hiatus. At the time, Soobin was one of Dal Shebet's busiest members. Not only was she on NBC's reality TV show, but she was simultaneously doing other shows outside of her regular Dal Shebet promotions. According to All K-Pop, Soobin did leave a heartwarming message to her fans in regards to recovery, and reads, "Are you doing well? I really miss you. I'm really late with this news, right? My surgery went well and I'm diligently going through rehabilitation treatments. I had a really hard time because of the sudden accident, but I'm getting a lot of strength from people and darlings who show me support and encouragement every day. I will quickly get better and show a good image with the other Shebet unis. I likewise really love you and miss you. Thank you." So Soobin opened up even more eventually about the car accident during a YouTube interview in 2020. According to Soompi, Soobin sat down with Life Update Olympics and responded to why she had to be on hiatus for so long during her recovery, and this is what she said: "I was a fixed member in 4 to 5 variety shows around 2013 and 2014. During that time, there was a big car accident. The car flipped over while going home after an event in Busan. A car crashed into our car on a winding path. The car flipped over. At the time, I thought I was dead because I had opened my eyes, but everything was black. I touched the ground and I could feel the grass, but there was no sensation in the lower half of my body while my upper half was shaking so much. Someone asked from above, "Are you okay, Subin?" And I thought, "I'm dead. I'm really dead." The voice that Subin heard at the time belonged to her manager, who was dangling from her seat while wearing her seatbelt at the top of the flipped over car. Subin added, "We sobbed together. The car roof had flown away and all of the dirt and glass from the outside came inside because the windows were shattered. I felt so sorry to the members because we could have been a successful group but had to rest because of me. That's when I started writing Dalshabed songs." Whoa, Subin went through a lot during that time, but I love that she still found the time and energy to contribute to the group anyways, and I'm glad that she healed from her injuries. On April 15, 2015, Dalshabet released their next EP called Joker is Alive with the title track Joker. Jazzy comeback is all about how the ladies are trying to get their love interest to understand their feelings. Apparently, the Joker in question is a flirt, and the ladies have a hard time keeping his attention on just them, yet they still have these strong feelings for him and want him to know that. It's a decent song, but I really wasn't crazy about it then and even now. I'll still give Subin her props for writing the song for the ladies. The EP peaked at number 8 and sold over 4.7k copies. On December 8, 2015, Happy Face Entertainment confirmed that Gaehyun and Jiyul would be leaving the agency and Dalshabet once their contracts expired. According to Soompi, the ladies wrote letters to their fans addressing the situation, and Jiyul states, "Since meeting Darlings in 2011 right up until now, the 5 years with Lovely Darlings and our members was a really happy time. And after discussions with my family, the members, our staff, etc., and debating a lot, I came to this decision. For me as well, it's really, really sad to be delivering this upsetting news, and I know will upset Darlings, but I wanted to be the first person to tell you all." Next, Gaehyun apologizes for not notifying the public sooner. She writes, "Until the last schedule, I wanted to go on as usual and have fun while completing my schedules cheerfully, so I couldn't tell you all sooner. Going forward, I will focus on fashion and style, which I have always had a lot of interest in and loved. I'll study it diligently and come back with a new image, so don't worry about me." Dalshabet continued as a quartet to release their next EP on January 5th, 2016, called Naturalness, in the track Someone Like You. Their best songs, pretty much up there with BBB for me. The ladies weren't into their love interest at first, but he won them over eventually. Then once in the relationship, the guy dumps them, but the girls are already in love with him, so of course that hurts. So now they're hoping that he finds someone just as cold and selfish and heartless as him to fall in love with so that he has a dose of his own medicine. It's actually a really great song, and Subin wrote this also herself. I love the dance and the outfits in this video as well. It's just a super upbeat, fun song to listen to, and I highly recommend it if you haven't heard it in full length. The EP peaked at number 10 on the charts and sold over 3.9k copies. Then on September 29, 2016, the ladies came back with the EP and matching title track Friday, Saturday, Sunday. This is such a fun and relatable song about hardworking people just wanting a break from the world. The ladies are letting everyone know that just for the weekend, they plan on not taking any calls or requests. They just want to have fun and do their own thing. And I can definitely say that I've been there and totally get it, which makes me appreciate this song all the more. I love their outfits for this comeback. The jeans and the black shirts and boots look so good on them. And the dances are really nice too. The EP peaked at number 12 and it sold over 3.6k copies. Then on December 14, 2017, Happy Face Entertainment confirmed that Ah Young, City, and Soobin will be leaving the agency once their contracts expired. According to Soompi, the agency released a statement in regards to the matter that reads, City, Ah Young, and Soobin's exclusive contracts with Happy Face Entertainment are ending in 2017. The three members plan on leaving Happy Face Entertainment to take on new challenges and showcase charms that they were unable to as Dal Shabet members. Seri and Ah Young and Soobin's new starts do not mean that Dal Shabet will be disbanding. Currently, all possibilities are open on the continuation of Dal Shabet as a team, and we are in discussion with the members. We will notify fans once a specific direction is decided. On December 5th, 2018, Wooyi's contract with Happy Face Entertainment has expired as well. So despite leaving their origin agency, the ladies consider themselves and Dal Shabet very much so intact. In fact, they have come out on different occasions to let us know that Dal Shabet hasn't disbanded. Soobin did an interview back in 2019 for Star One magazine, according to Soompi, and when asked about if Dal Shabet disbanded, she stated, "Lots of people ask whether Dal Shabet has disbanded, but we haven't," said Soobin. "Even at our New Year's get-together, the other Dal Shabet members and I talked about how we want to get together and promote as a group from now on." Wooyi also confirmed that Dal Shabet hasn't disbanded when she did an interview in 2018, according to aminoapps.com, and she states, "The members are in different agencies, but Dal Shabet hasn't disbanded. Sometimes we fight and swear, but we never break up. We have a good relationship, like we're really sisters. We're going to come out with a new song to make it up to our supportive fans. We're making a lot of effort in our respective positions to reunite as Dal Shabet. For the time being, all of our members are going to do their best in their responsibilities. It's unfortunate that we're not able to do group activities right now. We don't even want to use the expression that we're being foolish because all of us haven't given up yet. Aren't our senior idols like Hot and such guys showing us examples? We will definitely have a good side of us to the fans." During their time promoting, Dal Shabet released one album, 10 EPs, and 11 singles. They were nominated for one award, and they won 11 of them. Well, there you have it, people. This video was also requested, so thank you for that. I actually did a video on Dal Shabet, but it was taken down, apparently, and I had no idea. So the whole time I was creating this, I kept thinking, I've done this before, but I couldn't find the video anywhere. So I'm glad it was requested because I'm able to do it over and put more information in that I'm sure the first one was lacking. But anyways, let me know what your thoughts are on Dal Shabet. What was your favorite comeback, and who was your favorite member? And when do you think they will reunite? I honestly do feel they will come back. They have come back before for a reunion, so I do think they will give us a surprise one day soon. Let me know your thoughts, and I'll see you in the next one. Wassalam.